This is the stainless steel heating rod. You can buy it from Amazon. It's really cheap. I put it in the middle of the panettone to help me to help the mold to have uniform heats, so it's baked nicely. If you don't do that, then I'm going to show you a second one where I didn't use it and it collapsed in the middle. And that's a very natural thing because there is not enough heat in the middle of that giant panettone to help it to rise up. So that's one of the reasons why it collapsed. And that's why I use this stainless steel heating rod. Small ones, we're going to follow the same process, meaning we're going to flip the pan over something like a tart ring or another cake pan on the top of a cooling rack, so it has a space between your kitchen table and the mold itself, so it doesn't steam. It's not really necessary when you're dealing with 3 inches and 4 inches tall cake pan, but just to be safe. And also, I may use a parchment paper, I may not use it because, again, because it's quite because of its size. I personally like this small panettone mold or the bread because you can have your own individual panettone. You can freeze them separately. You can give them as a gift. They are very, very convenient. The one without the removable button, I put a parchment paper on the bottom so it's easy to remove. And finally, we have this beautiful panettone, nicely baked, and the texture is just wonderful. Well, I hope you enjoyed this video as much as I did, because this is really my favorite bread or cake. It's challenging, you did see it's challenging, but once you master it, it's a beauty. It's a masterpiece, and it tastes so, so good. I think by now you know what to do. Make sure you subscribe, ask your questions, put your comments, I'll be happy to answer them. Share this video with your friends and your family, and I hope to see you soon. Goodbye. Taste it for you. Very good, very good.